Use the snowstorm to mask your approach. Having second thoughts?
Hardly. But I'll have to approach this carefully.
Go on, then. I'll keep watch from here.
I can hide in that cart.
In the wagon. I need a full inventory.
As you wish. Let's see. 2 barrels of salt, 12 pounds pork, 10 pounds beef, 7 dozen eggs, 16 wheels of cheese, none of it French, don't worry, 5 bottles of whiskey, a couple dozen new uniforms, boots, and leather for patching, blankets, a cart for feed for the horses. What else? That's it. That's all there is.
Those cannons are like to cause trouble. Perhaps I could sabotage them.
Be no truce.
Damn it! Why, George? What reason did he give?
He said a diplomatic solution was no solution at all. That allowing the French to retreat would only delay an inevitable conflict, one in which they'd now have the upper hand.
There's merit to those words, as much as I hate to admit it. Still, can't he see this is unwise?
He doesn't sit well with me. Far from home with our forces divided. Worse, I fear Braddock's bloodlust makes me careful. Puts them at a risk. I'd rather not be delivering grim news to mothers and widows because the bulldog wanted to prove a point.
Where is the general now?
Rallying the troops.
And then it's on to Fort Duquesne, I assume?
Ha! Eventually. The march north will surely take time. There's a copy of the plans in the command tent should you wish to review them.
At least this will be ended.
I tried, John. I know, my friend. I know.
That map will surely be of use. I need to find it.
Is this a snake's pit?
Ha!
citizen of Scotland. A sporting gentleman.
What news?
Braddock has left to rally his troops. They're marching on Fort Duquesne. It'll be a while yet till they're ready, which gives us time to form a plan.
No need. We will ambush him here near the river. Go and gather your allies. I will do the same. I will send word when it is time to strike.